Hi everyone, just a quick content warning that the following episode has clips that contain the sounds of war and gunfire. Hey Star, are you ready?
I'm a lady!
And welcome to Idol Days, the show about idol anime. I'm Sarah.
And I'm Star.
And today we're doing a show that Star recommended to me.
Following in the train of we recommended shows to each other last time, Sarah told me to watch Given and I cried about it. And then this week and also next week, I told Sarah to watch a show.
AKB0048!
Pachu! Arguably the best idol anime.
You've heard of idols, but have you heard of idols in space?
Idols in space!
I mean, technically we have heard about idols in space. I was realizing, Star, that all of our recommendations to each other were just like upgraded versions of our Cursed October shows.
Wait. Oh shit, because I watched the fucking samurai band show.
Mm-hmm. And then you watch Band Boys.
And I... and you watched Idols in Space, and then you watched Idols in Space again, but less horny, maybe.
So, AKB0048, just preface before we get into it, it was a wild ride and I loved it.
I'm so glad.
It's absolutely ridiculous. Okay, so, if you haven't heard of AKB... AKB48 is a real idol group.
Mm-hmm.
That is related to, but also separate from this anime. The real idol group, AKB48, are not idols in space.
But they should be.
They are idols in Akihabara.
Mm-hmm.
They've been around since 2005. There's a ton of them.
There's like several hundred of them.
Yeah.
It's very hard to keep track of.
So they're arguably probably, I would say, the most well-known idol group in Japan.
Mm-hmm.
They are known for having, first of all, a lot of girls. They have, like, main groups. So, like, I think there's now, like, 15 or so, maybe more or less. And then, like, there's main girls, and they audition to get into AKB. But when they get in, they're trainees. And then from there, they audition more, or there's also, like, random competitions. One of them's, like, selling CDs, and there was also, like, a rock, paper, scissors one for a while to, like, become part of the main group.
Oh, man.
Yeah, so AKB48, so that's the real-life AKB group. They're known for, like, having their own stage in Akihabara. They have all these things around Japan and Asia in general. They're, like, the group in Wake Up Girls.
Yeah, the I-1.
The I-1 cult, which was mm-hmm. definitely being spoofed on.
Yeah, this is the real-life equivalent that I-1 was probably based on.
And then AKB0048 is taking on the existing AKB franchise thing, and they are...
And launching them into space!
Launching them into space! They're saying, 50,000 years from now, or whenever the heck it is, AKB will still be around... And they're still doing idol performances.
But instead, of just, like, you know, taking on, like, auditioning and becoming your own person, you take over the persona of a long-dead original AKB member.
Yup. So all the girls who are, like, the main AKB in AKB0048, they're known as successors.
Mm-hmm, because they are the successors to the title of I am Yuko Oshima the 19th or what have you. And so she's like the 19th iteration. I'm not getting the numbers right, but you get the idea.
And just especially making it confusing, if you're Googling these characters' names, all the successors are names of actual AKB members. AKB48 mm-hmm. members that were members when the anime was being made. But they're not voiced by them. They're just named after them.
No. Okay, so what I remember... Okay, so I watched this show, like, I guess around the time when it first came out. Mm-hmm. It had been out for a few years when I watched it. I remember we were both in college. We were still living it together at the time. And I was like, Sarah, you gotta watch this show. It's bonkers. And your response was, eh. apparently what I've read is that the actual AKB successors in the show are voiced by professional voice actors.
Yes.
But the understudies, the group that the show focuses on, like mm-hmm. the trainees, they were voiced by AKB members.
Yes.
Not the specific ones, but they were, like, that's where they sourced the voice actresses from.
Yes. So, those are the ones they got for, like, the main characters. It's, like, a subgroup of actual AKB called No Name, which is, like, mm-hmm. wow, that's a harsh name. But,
yeah.
I mean, actually, a lot of them were, like, part of the main AKB group, so they were all pretty popular.
I don't know who's who. I just know that that was the thing that they did when casting the show.
So if you couldn't tell from this confusing opening, there's a lot of girls.
Oh my god, there's so many girls. You will not remember all of their names. We're not even going to bother introducing them all.
No. So why don't I get into who the characters are and then we'll get into the show?
Sure.
Okay.
I'm excited to hear you try and describe this plethora of girls.
There's so many girls.
I feel like there's a lot that are way more important than the others. Because, like, I'm looking at this lineup of girls, and I can still remember half of their names. Like, I remember the ones who are more important to the plot than the rest.
So, main character, I would say. Main character, her name is Nagisa.
Mm-hmm.
She has, like, pink hair. It's like chin length bob sort of cut.
Mm-hmm.
It's really, really fluffy. And then partially through, she gets like a little side ponytail.
Yeah, she looks like Sakura from Zombieland Saga if she cut her hair.
Yeah, that's a good way to put it. So, mm-hmm. but she has short pink hair. So main character, Nagisa. She's one of the important
yep.
ones.
Mm-hmm.
The other one that I would say is important is Chieri. She has long, flowy, mm-hmm. light bluish, tealish hair.
Yeah, that, like, goes down to her knees.
Yes, and she has, like, bluish eyes. And all the people I'm describing right now, this is going to get confusing really fast, they all are not, mm-hmm. at the beginning of the episode, they are not members of AKB, all the people I'm describing.
No.
Right now.
Our group of main characters are not in the group, but they will be sort of.
So we have Nagisa, we have Chieri. And then mm-hmm. also living, so those two are introduced at the beginning. Also, like, I guess childhood friends, you find this out immediately. There is Orine. She has, like, pink hair. It's kind of blobby.
Yeah, it's, like, a little bit like cotton candy texture. Like, her, you know how in anime you can have the pointy hair, you can have soft hair? She's got soft hair.
Yeah, she has soft hair. And then there is Yuka, and she has, like, twin tails and blonde hair. And they're really mm-hmm. long twin blonde tails.
Yeah.
Okay, so those four are the first four you get introduced to.
You only really need to remember the first two.
You only really need to remember Nagisa and Chieri. The others are mentioned. Mm-hmm. They come up just...
Like, they're around, but they don't have much import to the
There's
plot.
There's so many people. So the other group of trainees that you end up meeting, you then also meet Sonata. And mm-hmm. she has, like, orangish hair. She always has, like, animal ears on, so she usually mm-hmm. has, like, bunny ears or bear ears or something. She's young-looking.
Mm-hmm.
Then there's Makoto. She has, like, gray-blue hair and a side ponytail. She doesn't talk much.
Side ponytail. No. She really doesn't.
And then there's Suzuko, and she has glasses and greenish curly hair that's really short, like, chin length.
Yeah.
So those are all the people who have not been in AKB yet, and they're all trainees. And then amending yes. this, there are also two more characters who are introduced. There's so many people.
There's so many people. We're not even halfway there.
No, we're not even halfway there.
Do you want to introduce the other two when we meet them?
That's a good idea. We'll introduce them when we meet them.
So there are six characters at this point. You only need to remember Nagisa, main character, red hair, and Chieri, blue hair, other main character.
Yes.
The others you can forget about. I'm sorry if you're a fan of those characters listening to this episode. We have to cull it down somehow.
There's
too many to talk about.
There are
so many.
Okay, so we have the initial trainees that we'll talk about. These are the only people who really show up in the first few episodes. I mean, others do, but it's too much. It's too petty.
Just focus on them. Just focus on them. Just put your blinders on and keep walking. It's okay, Sarah. We can get through this.
All right. Now I need you to imagine. Close your eyes and imagine. It is the future.
I'm okay.
And in this future, entertainment is banned.
Oh?
There are cops everywhere. And also everywhere there's these signs and they just say no idols with a slash through. So,
yep.
I was telling my wife, and she's like, "We need those signs in our house." I was like, "No,
no. This is a certified no idol zone.
Certified no idol zone. It's like instead of no parking signs, picture no idol signs."
Yeah.
And in this distant dark future, you see four little girls, and they're all wearing frilly dresses, and they are running through the mines of this planet called Lancaster.
Through the mines.
Yes, because it's a mining planet. It's all...
Okay.
Yes. Hard work.
And why are they in the mines, Sarah?
Because they are running to go see a secret idol show by AKB0048. I know.
Immediately, these girls are doing crimes.
They are doing crimes immediately. And the four girls you see are the two important ones, Nagisa and Chiari, and then also... Pink bubble hair, Orine, and Yuka twin tails, Tsundere girl. And they sneak out, they go into the mines, and they look out, and there is an idol show, and AKB0048 is performing.
Now, Sarah, I know exactly what scene you're talking about, because I used to show this at my panel. I need you to describe what this idol concert looks like.
So, first of all, they're all in, like, because, like, it's a mining place, so they're all in, like, this pit.
Like, it's almost a crater.
And then from the sky descends a giant spaceship, and the spaceship opens up to show a stage, and on the stage, AKB is dancing, and they're dancing, and then each of the little platforms they're standing on breaks apart, and they start dancing and flying along on their little platform things. Right?
They're like hoverboards.
Yes. And I guess just so to give you another visual, AKB0048, it kind of has like our what we call the love live rules. When it's full body, it's usually 3D animated, and then waist up or detail shots is 2D. And then while they're doing their little dancing and they're doing their little concert and all the four little girls we see are all amazed, all of a sudden there is an attack.
By who, Sarah?
By the... Destroy Entertainment Soldiers, known as the DES. And
the DES.
The DES. And the DES comes in, guns a-blazing, literally, like they have weapons. And they start shooting at these dancing idol girls. And the dancing idol girls, while still singing, they're still doing their little song and dance, start taking out the soldiers with, like, parts of their outfit. Like, I think one of the characters has, like, a little bow, and she, like, puts the bow and it, like, tases the guy. And the other part that they all have is their microphones turn into lightsabers.
Yep. So, like, when you're imagine you're holding a microphone with the, like, audio sensing piece in front of your mouth, the part that sticks out the other end, it expands into a fucking lightsaber. Like, it's incredible. But yeah, so Takamina, one of the characters we'll meet later, she's got, like, this little hair bow attached to a string, and she can whip it out, and it's a taser, and then it, like, retracts, and she just clicks it back into her hair. One of the other characters has, like, this magical girl wand that's a taser. It's phenomenal. This show is great. I used to show this opening number at my, like, Let's Learn About Idol Anime panel, and I would always just show this clip with zero context and be like, if there's anything you don't understand, don't worry. This is the first 5 minutes of the show.
Yeah, that it's out of context for everyone who watches it for the first time. I showed it to Athena, and her response was AKB stands for All Cops Bad. Which I love.
God, they were really ahead of their time.
I mean, it was 2012. We were pretty much at the time. But yeah. So they're fighting and these four little girls are watching and they're like, wow, idols are amazing. And then these little glowy alien things start floating around them.
Oh, God, I forgot about the glowy aliens.
Yup. And they're like, wow, we want to join AKB0048.
And we're not going to explain the glowy aliens at all.
Yet.
They look like weird little jellyfish.
Yep.
Da 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 da. Oh, so, Sarah, I realized we forgot to talk about this at the top of the show.
Uh-huh.
Would you like to explain to our audience how you watched this show?
Oh, yes. I would love to explain how I watched this show. So, when it first aired, it was simulcast on Crunchyroll. And
that's how I watched it.
And then at some point at the beginning of last year, they took all a bunch of Sentai Filmwork shows down off of Crunchyroll. So I could not find it. But Star recommended it to me, and I really, really wanted to watch it. So I went on eBay, and I haggled down to get both sets of the DVDs for $20. Hey!
Hey! Athena told me you guys were watching the dub, too.
I was switching it out. So I would watch... I feel like every other episode I would switch it, unless there was a scene that I'm like, I really want to know what they said in the other language. And then I switch it. Yeah.
Power move.
Yes. So kind of both.
But yeah, I remember, like, because when you told me, oh no, it got taken off of Crunchyroll, I was like, oh shit, should I find another show for you to watch? And you were like, no.
No, I got this.
I got this.
I got
it
this.
It was incredible. Power move.
So yes, I own AKB0048 DVDs.
Yep.
They have Blu-rays too, but I mean, $20 for two seasons is a pretty good deal, so.
Yeah. It's like less than a dollar per episode. I think you made it out in the good in this end.
So, flash forward. It's, I assume, like, maybe like 4 years later. And the little girls are now teens.
Teens.
And you get to know them as adults. The main character, you see, she was one of the four little girls, was Nagisa. So, short hair, Sakura with her hair cut short. And she's in school with Yuka. So, they're both in school. La la la, they're doing school stuff. And then Yuka is on her phone communicator thing. And
on your phone in class.
Ooh. I know. And she finds out that AKB is now accepting auditions for new trainees. And she's like, oh my God, we have to audition and we have to talk to Orine about this, who is pink bubble hair girl. And she was also one of the little girls. Orine is not at the school. She's working in a factory because she's like an orphan.
Oh, God, I remember that.
Yeah. Like, it's already like, wow, this is... See, like, here's the thing is, like, other idol shows, like, the stakes are like, oh, I'm poor and I have to please my family, or, oh, my father disapproves. But they have all of that on top of the fact that it's, like, this dystopian future.
Yeah, like, damn.
So they all meet up and they're like, okay, we're all going to audition for AKB48. Entertainment, like, apparently after this AKB concert they saw when they were little, apparently entertainment was no longer banned, it was just restricted because the concert changed so many people's opinions, blah blah blah, political upheaval because of idol concert.
Yeehaw, that's what we like to see.
Right? So they
love me some renegade idols.
So they meet up and they're like, okay, we're gonna audition. We'll film each other taking videos. And then this is also where you learn that new members, quote, take on the former idol's name and legacy. So this is when you start learning that once you become an official frontline member of AKB0048, become an actual successor, then you no longer have your name or your look. They style you and they rename you to be named after these original AKB48 members.
Which is a wild concept.
Yep.
Like, I want to know who pitched this.
Yup.
I want to know why this got chosen to be the thing. I feel like for those first few generations, there would have been, like, a public outcry of, like, the people who are super into AKB. It's like, are you trying to replace the originals? And they're like, no, we're taking on their name and legacy. That's replacing them, basically.
That's wild. So that's where you find that out. First episode, They don't really explain it. You're like, oh, they must have mistranslated this. Nope. That's what happens.
Nope. Nope.
All right, so they all, like, film each other for auditions. Nagisa, it's notable that she feels too shy to sing on her audition, but she pulls through anyway. Another thing you find out towards the beginning is that Yuka has a boyfriend on her little city of Lancaster.
Ooh.
I know.
Can't have that if you're an idoloo.
Mm-hmm, so all of that's going on. And then you have, like, all this cutesy, kind of weird... these girls auditioning for an idol in the space on a planet. And then that cuts to a room with these, like, Tory gates, but they look really mechanical. And
oh,
then
yeah.
There's all these ladies in, like shrine maiden costumes.
Mm-hmm.
And a glow from the darkness.
Uh-huh. Yes.
And then they're like, we must call upon the holy lyric. And you're like, okay.
This is the predecessor to the wall in 22-7.
I think so. Oh, no, 22-7 is our time. This is what happens after.
Oh, this is the future of the wall. This is the wall's great, 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 great grand wall.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what happened.
Oh, shit.
So, apparently, this weird being in the darkness... you're kind of implying that these people in their shrine maiden outfits, this is what decides who's moving on in the audition process.
Mm-hmm. So. There's a large, just light in a cave that decides who gets to be idols.
Yep, in space somewhere.
Uh-huh. We love it when you have a large, semi-sentient, like, chaos being who is deciding all of your business decisions.
We say that it's the wall's great-great-great-grandchild, but maybe it's just the wall, because walls don't die.
Sarah.
Yes.
All idols are warlocks, and this is their patron.
Whoa. I love it.
Great. Okay. New D&D character. I want to make a great old patron who's just the wall.
The wall.
Or, like, the voice in the cave from AKB. And they're like... all the idols. They, yep. Like, manage an idol group. That sounds like a fun idea for a campaign.
It does,
that would involve everyone being warlocks.
Yup.
Oh, boy. Anyway. There's our talking about D&D quota for the episode. Next.
Back on Lancaster. So, that's going on in space. Back on Lancaster, all three of the girls find out that they passed the first round of auditions.
Da-da-da-da-da-da!
But then you also find out that Nagisa, her dad, is a entertainment administration bureau chief.
Oh.
And he's like, I can't have you have idol posters in your house or sing or do any idol things because it'll look bad on me and it could get me in trouble and cause problems with our family and also with the politics of our entire planet.
But, Dad, I want to sing.
And he's like, but child, this could cause political upheaval and cause millions to die.
And then Nagisa's like, but Dad!
So Nagisa delivers the bad news to Yuka and Orine. I just want to mention, while they're on Lancaster, they all ride electric unicycles.
Yes.
Which is pretty great.
Yes. Excellent.
This causes a rift between, like, Yuka and Orine. And so essentially, Yuka and Orine... pink, bubbly hair and twin tails. They're like, okay, well, we made a promise back when we were little and in the caves that all four of us will become idols together. And you're already like, I wonder what happened to fourth girl.
Yeah, I was just about to ask, like, where's Sherry at this point?
Where is she?
She was
where
there too.
She? It's a mystery. So she's like, well, all of us decide we're going to become idols together and you're just a coward and we'll become an idol without us. Don't look back, blah, blah, blah. So Orine and Yuka start, like, saying their goodbyes on their planet because they might not ever see home again because they're going to be idols.
Yep.
Yuka breaks up with her boyfriend and her boyfriend's like, I hate idols. I'll never support you. And she's like, well, fuck you.
Who needs boys when you have idols?
Right? Orine's at her factory, like, it's her and all these old ladies, and she etches, like, the word Sakura into, like, a plate or, like, a part for a metal, big giant metal part of whatever she's manufacturing, being like, I'll visit again when the sakura bloom. And you're like, there are no plants on this planet. It's so depressing.
Okay, whatever.
And so, like, the next day when they're about to take off, because they sent AKB0048 sent like a cruise ship plane to go pick them up for the last round of auditions.
Mm-hmm.
They're like, okay, I guess Nagis is not joining us. So they go on the plane and they're all like, and Yuka's all like, Nagisa is such a coward. She doesn't love us. And then Nagisa wakes up and she's like, no, I have to do this.
I gotta be an idol.
And her mom like gives her like a little bow, and that gives her her little side ponytail that mm-hmm. she didn't have up till this point, because apparently the person she wants to succeed has a side ponytail. Like, she's in. So she rides her unicycle going really, really fast, this electric unicycle, and while the plane's taking off, she catches up to it, and Yuka and Orine like open the escape door, and they grab her and they pull her in last second before the plane goes warp speed into the space.
Powerful. She must have like some yes. She must run really fast.
Well, she was on her electric unicycle.
Oh, okay. That makes more sense. Mm-hmm. But still, though, a fucking plane taking off?
Yup. A spaceship, even.
Damn. Girl.
So that's episode one. This is the universe we're living in right now.
I love it.
All right. So episode two, they are... Apparently, they are at, like, some sort of space airport to get onto their next step of whatever, the space cruise.
Mm-hmm.
And just like behind them on the news, there is some news about some sort of CEO's daughter is missing, right?
Uh-oh.
And they show a picture of a girl with long blue hair, and you're like, that's Chieri. It's also the little girl at the beginning.
Oh, shit.
But we don't know that yet, technically. And then we also hear the OP for the first time. So the OP is sung by the members of the group No Name, the ones who are the voice actors of the main girls.
Mm-hmm.
So it's sung by AKB people. I think it was written for the anime, from what I understand.
I'm pretty sure it was, yeah.
Because I think the subgroup was made for the anime. It's very dramatic. There's a lot of, like, silhouettes of girls dancing and crying. And it's oh, really yeah. emotional. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then they all are on the space cruiser. Nagisa, Orine, and Yuka start talking, and they're like, wow, I wonder what Chiri's up to now. Like, she was with us just for that one summer when we saw the AKB0048 concert. I wonder if she auditioned too. And that's when you start meeting the other trainees that we introduced at the beginning. You meet Makoto.
Mm-hmm.
This is blue hair, side ponytail. Her personality is she's like shy and scared, and she big imposter syndrome. She's like, I don't think I'm good enough for this. Then you also meet Sonata. She's the short one. Her personality is she's like really like haughty. She's like, oh yes, I'm gonna be the best idol, and do you want my autograph? I'll give you my autograph.
Sort of Himedere at this point.
Yeah, a little gremlin-y too. So kind of both. When you find her, she's like hiding out on the space cruiser. Like, she's not in public. She's, like, hiding behind a vending machine, and, like, when the girls are talking, she, like, hides under the table because she's not supposed to be there. Because you find out she did not pass the first round of auditions, but she's going there to make her case anyways.
Oh, shit.
And then you also meet Suzuko, green hair, glasses, curly hair. One thing that's notable here is that she meets Sonata first, and Sonata just, like, out of the blue gives her her autograph on, like, a vending machine can.
Mm-hmm.
And then is like, thank you, Linda. And Suzuko's like, who's Linda? And Sonata's like, that's your name now. So whenever they're together, Suzuko goes by Linda. I'm never going to say that again. But no.
It will be a miracle if we talk about these characters ever again.
So basically, all the girls at some point meet up, and they all find out that they are all here to audition to do the second round to get into AKB0048 as trainees.
Mm-hmm.
And while they're sitting around and they're talking, they get approached by, like, the ship's captain and some soldiers. And they're like, hey, have you seen an escapee It's the CEO's daughter of this company. And they're like, oh, shit. They look up at the TV. And when they see this, they're like, oh, wait, the CEO's daughter. That's Chieri. And she's missing. And she's on the ship. Let's go look for her. So they all split up and they all go look around. And then at some point, Nagisa runs into one of those floaty alien things from the first concert.
The little jellyfish.
And then she starts following it. And then when she follows it, she runs into a figure and all their hair is stuffed under their hat. And you can't really see their face. And you're like, oh, yes, this is totally not Chieri for sure.
Totally. No. Chieri has too much hair. It wouldn't fit under a hat.
Totally not Chieri is like, yes, you found the little alien thingy. It's so sad. It used to glow, but ever since it followed me away from the planet I took it from, it hasn't glown. And you're like, oh, no, no glow. And then Nagisa's like, wait a second. Are you Chieri? And Chieri like is like, well, yeah, and I'm here to audition. And also, you should just go ahead and turn me into the cops because you're my rival now since we're all trainees. And every time someone succeeds in these idol industries, it just makes someone else sad. And you're like, wow, this is some harsh truth in our sci-fi space idol anime.
Yep.
Because it's like the whole concept of like when you're auditioning, some people are going to get in and some people aren't. So everyone's your rival. So people can't necessarily be friends. You know, we've seen that in idol shows before.
Oh, yeah.
So Chieri walks off into the like abyss in the ship. She goes back to hiding. And Nagisa is all sad because she's like, oh, I'm not going to be friends with Chieri anymore. But also maybe we can be if we become idols together.
Mm-hmm.
So then the group all come back together and they all talk about basically what Chieri said, like, are we competitors? Are we rivals? Are we friends? And then in the middle of this conversation, there is an attack!
Dun-dun-dun!
And apparently the DES found out that there are AKB trainees on here and also the whole Chieri escaping thing. So essentially all the girls are running from the DES soldiers. All the DS are like, they're like mech suits. They look like Spartans from Halo. Like, it's intense. And like at some point, Nagisa gets grabbed by the DES and all hope seems lost. And then Idol's music starts playing over the sound system. And then you find out that AKB is here to save the trainees.
Yay!
Yay!
The idol loser here.
I would like to quote some internal monologue from Nagisa. Quote, these people aren't just cute girls singing. They're also putting their lives on the line to save others. Go to the airlock. So idols in this future have a large higher stake situation.
Mm-hmm. You need to learn more than just how to sing and dance. You need to know how to kick ass too.
Yep. At some point, while Nagisa is escaping with everyone but Chieri, because Chieri is hiding somewhere in the plane, she realizes she lost her hair bow that her mom gave her.
Oh,
and
no.
She goes back for it, which, like, you know, and other things would be like, you went back for your hair bow, but then I'm also like, you might never see your parents again, so,
yeah. You know.
So she goes to get her hair bow, runs into Chieri and also some other DES soldiers. DS are shooting up the room. A chandelier falls on Chieri, and she's like,
wait, there's a chandelier on the spaceship?
Well, it's like a space cruise. Okay. Right? It's like a giant cruise ship spaceship.
Okay.
And Chieri is like, go without me. I'm your competition anyway. There's no need to save me. And then Nagi says, you're wrong. We're rivals, but we're also members of the same team. And, like, they have, like, this emotional moment together. And then Chieri's alien thing starts shining.
Mm-hmm.
And then we meet one of the successors at this point. So, new character.
Yes.
All right. And this is Yuko.
Best girl!
She has, like, orangey brown hair. She has the side ponytail. So you're assuming all this must be the person that mm-hmm. Nagisa likes.
She kind of has Honoka hair, but it's like spikier and she's got like weird little side braids kind of like worked into her ponytail.
She also has a little fang, but not a flesh fang, a tooth fang.
Yeah, like an acceptable fang.
An acceptable fang. And Yuko, like, you know, busts into the room and she sees this bright light from the alien and she's like internal monologue like, oh, it's the birth of a new idol. And you're like, okay. And then apparently you find out that these alien things are called Kiraras. Mm-hmm. And they are drawn to idols and start growing, glowing bright when there's a new idol. So you're like, okay, these aliens are like idol sensors. Sure.
Beep, 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 beep.
And then Yuko starts singing and uses her idol power to lift up the chandelier and rescues Chieri and Nagisa and takes them out of the airlock. And they go into safe space.
Yay.
They like hyperdrive away. Yep.
Pachu.
So that's episode 2.
The show is so bonkers. I love it.
It's wild. So episode 3, they're now on like the main AKB0048 ship, mm-hmm. right? So the trainees you've met are on the ship, the 7 of them. There is also the successors are there, which they're the ones who saved them. You met Yuko already. And then also a bunch of other girls who are there for the second round of auditions, but you know immediately that they're not getting in because they don't have multicolored hair. Like, it's pretty obvious these are not main characters.
Yeah, for real. Like, everybody in this show has, like, little hair gradients. They all have hearts in their hair and their eyes. Like, literal, like, heart shinies.
Yep. So you're like, okay, these girls aren't going to make it past the first round.
You don't have the energy. You don't have the vibe or the hair hearts.
Not the vibe. And then you get introduced to another character. And this is their producer, Tsubasa. Mm-hmm. She has, like, I guess short hair, but like a like blunt cut bangs. It's like a light blonde. And she mm-hmm. wears glasses. And she wears kind of like a flight attendant sort of uniform all the time.
Yeah.
And she describes what's going to be going on with the audition process. They are going to go through this audition process. Their song for the audition is the AKB song Beginner. Mm-hmm. Most of the songs in the anime are songs that already were like AKB album songs.
Yeah.
So it's like, oh, throwback for the fans.
Yeah, like the only AKB songs I know are the ones that are in this anime.
And the winners of this round of auditions will become official trainees and they will be moved into a dormitory on the planet Akihabara.
Yep, because Akihabara is now an entire planet.
Yeah, in which case I'm like, this is Idol Project. this is Idol Project.
It's Idol Planet.
Yep, there's an
Welcome
Idol Planet.
To Idol Planet.
Yep.
It's like Cat Planet, but it's Idol Planet.
They also give all the trainees their mic sabers. So they're like, okay, here's your combat weapons.
Don't stab yourself in the leg with it.
And they're like, okay, let's start training you guys for the second round of auditions.
Oh, I just remembered what happens next.
So all the girls start training, and it is a mix of, like, singing, dancing, and then also, like, weapon training. Uh-huh. Like, they give the idols guns.
Yeah, no, I just remembered what happens in this episode.
Yup, it's a lot. So all the girls are training, and apparently in a few days, Tsubasa also announces that after, like, while they're still training, AKB0048 is going to have a guerrilla live on this anti-idol planet, mm-hmm. and the auditioners, it's their job to protect the successors, mm-hmm. and that's why you're also getting this combat training right away, too.
Yep.
Right?
Because they have to keep their idols safe.
Yes. And Tsubasa's like, if you can't pass this test, you would die as a member of 00. And you're like, oh, stakes are high.
Yep. I legitimately wonder if anyone has ever died in the idol group. Because they seem to imply that, right? But like, that's
yeah.
so fucking dark for this extremely colorful anime.
Yeah.
Now, granted, we have to finish this episode before we talk
oh, yes,
about
we
dark,
do.
But... Mm.
So all the girls, like all the auditioners and also the auditioners who definitely won't make it pass because they don't have hearts in their eyes, they're all like kind of complaining and sad. They're like, oh, I wish we didn't have to do all this combat training and we could just sing songs and dance.
Weak.
But even then, they're not doing great at singing songs and dancing. Yuka brings this up with Chieri around and Chieri is like, well, you just aren't serious enough to be an idol. This doesn't really count. And it causes more tension because you're like, oh, these girls who used to be childhood friends are all mad at each other. And Chieri is like, she's like, you know, the character who's like super serious. Like, I'm going to become an idol no matter what.
Mm-hmm.
You get them in almost every anime.
Yeah.
So Nagisa is like, Chieri, you're just not being cool. Stop it. So also there's some other parts where, because you learn that the Kirara, the
jellyfish,
little alien floaty things, yeah, the jellyfish are attracted to idols, you get separate like thoughts where Nagisa's like, oh, I'm sad that the Kirara follow Chieri and not me, so that must mean she's meant to be an idol and not me. And the Chieri is thinking the Kirara only glowed for Nagisa and not me, even though it's been around all this time. Nagisa must be an idol, not me. Mm-hmm. They all have the separate, like, oh, the other person must be the real idol.
Yeah. When in reality, Yuko was there, so it's like, hello.
Hello.
I'm idol.
And then it's concert day.
Dun, 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 dun.
And all of the idols... or all of the auditioners are put on this alien planet, and they have their guns, they have their combat uniforms, they're ready to go, and the successors give their cheer, they go ahead and start their concert. The trainees are holding their guns, they're like clutching them, and there's like war-torn landscape, like...
Yeah, they're like in the trenches.
They're like in trenches. And then there's an enemy attack. Like gunfire, mechs. Meanwhile, the concert's going on. It's the AKB song Beginner, which is like really dramatic. The girls are attacked, like the trainees are attacked. There's blood. Some of the trainees get gunned down and don't get back up.
Yeah, I remember very specifically that like this scene, it cuts back and forth repeatedly between cute idol concert and girls in the trenches getting gunned down.
Yep. So all of the ones who you've met and have names are still fighting hard. Nagisa's thinking back, like, it's only been a month, but even after this month, I'm no longer a normal girl. This is my life now.
This is my life. I live in the trenches. This is what it means to be an idol.
At some point, Nagisa and Chieri meet up with each other. Chieri, like, runs out and draws fire while Nagisa like throws a grenade, and then at that point there's a laser sight on Nagisa's chest and Chieri jumps in front and then gets shot.
Yeah. Rip, anime's over.
And then like there's like this scene of like Nagisa holding Chieri like Michelangelo's Pietà, and like storm clouds are gathering overhead, and meanwhile AKB0048 successors finish singing their song.
Yep.
And you're like, oh my god. We're like, they just die?
Yeah.
Like, we joke about them dying, but they just die?
Yeah. Rip.
But then Chieri opens her eyes and is like, oh, hey, I'm still alive, what? And they're like, wait, you're still alive, what? And then Nagisa reaches down at the blood on Cherry's chest, and she's like, oh, it's just a paintball.
I wonder why those other girls didn't get back up. Oh, right? No.
Oh, no.
They weren't main characters. They were expendable.
They were actually dead. And then Orine, Suzuko, Sonata, Yuka, like all the other girls that are named, they all meet with them, and then... Tsubasa jumps out of a mech, their manager jumps out of a mech and was like, good job. And apparently the concert was a success. And actually, this was just the last step in their auditions.
Gotta love being gaslit by your future management.
Yeah, by like thinking you're going to actually die to be an idol.
Like, do you really want to be an idol that bad?
So, yeah, concert was a success. They all passed the test, and some people might not have died.
Might.
So yay, no one died. This cuts back to the creepy Tori shrine place. The light from the darkness just says eternity from inside the ring. And they're like, wow, this is a new word. And you're like, okay.
Whatever weird voice in space.
Yep. So weird voice in space. They passed the audition. This is just a test to see that A, they were combat ready, and B, that they cared enough about their fellow trainees to like self-sacrifice and jump in front of a bullet.
I'd catch your grenade for ya, or however that song goes.
Yeah, no, exactly. So they all go, all the people who pass, the new trainees, they go back on the ship. The successors are all like, oh, hey, congratulations, you did it. And then it also feels like after the self-sacrifice, the tension with Chieri is not as tension-y. So they're all friends now.
He's like, you caught a grenade for me. Just like in that one song who I can't remember who sings it.
It's been 5,000 years, literally.
But it still gets played on the radio for some reason.
Episode 4, all the trainees end up on Akiba Star.
Yay, Idol Planet.
And they visit the official AKB stage on the Idol Planet. And here's where you meet two more characters who are relatively important.
Yep.
There is Memori, mm-hmm. and she has, like, purpley-pinky hair that kind of gradates into, like, a peachy pink on the tips.
Yeah.
It's very long and flowy. And then Kanata.
Other best girl.
And she is one of the other ones who's important. And she has red hair and a really high, like, up-down ponytail.
Mm-hmm. It's, like, ponytail on top. But then she still has some hair, like, that's not in the ponytail.
Yes. And you find out that these two idols are part of the quote-unquote unlucky generation, where basically everyone else from their generation didn't pass the auditions or dropped out. So it's just the two of them. And none of them have become successors yet.
Mm-hmm.
And they're, like, the generation right before the new trainees.
Yep.
Which
makes you wonder why they're recruiting if they still have this generation that hasn't been recruited anyone yet.
Well, the spooky guy from the gate said so. The knot wall.
Well, you know, this spooky voice in a cave makes all of our business decisions, so, you know.
Yep.
If I had a nickel every time there was a show about a creepy voice that makes business decisions for idol companies, I'd have two nickels, which isn't a lot, but it's weird that it's happened twice.
There might even be more, so.
Oh, God, you put that possibility out there, and now we're going to have people in our DMs be like, oh, actually, there's more, and I'm going to be like, what?
Why are there so many?
I should have said more than a nickel.
So, right. Could be rich. So the two of them do like a duo performance. A thing that's notable is nobody in the audience is really paying attention to them. It's like they're using their performance as like break time. And the other girls are like, oh no, that's so sad. And then the main AKB successors perform.
Mm-hmm.
And they get like a huge crowd like, heck yeah, you did it.
Yep.
So after this concert, all the other trainees meet the two girls from the unlucky generation. So they meet Memori and Kanata. And then you find out that Kanata is Sonata's older sister. Like, actually. Like, they're related.
Which one is Sonata?
She's the one who has, like, animal ears all the time.
Oh, yeah. Itty-bitty one.
Yeah, the small one who technically wasn't a trainee.
Gotcha.
Or didn't pass the auditions. But after all of that, they're like, okay, you're in. Memori and Kanata show the group around the new dorms on Akiba Star. They have, like, they're, like, living in a mansion. Like, they have, like, their own personal chef and, like, these fancy rooms. So, yep, that's where they are now. The girls, like, get into their own dorms. They have, like, two sets of dorm rooms. Chieri and Nagisa are in the same room. Suzuka is also there, but there's some scenes where, like, the two of them are in the room talking.
Mm-hmm. Main characters gotta have main character time.
Oh, yes, absolutely. And then you find out that there's, like, this giant library in this mansion. And Suzuko green hair, glasses, the one who's a fan of Sonata. Apparently, the reason why she auditioned is because she's a huge fan of AKB and idols in general. So she's going through this library, and she finds out that there was a previous thing that AKB0048 had called a Center Nova.
Mm-hmm. Yep, here we go.
Yes. Or at least a little bit of it. This is like, I don't know, foreshadowing.
Mm-hmm.
The Center Nova hasn't been around since 13th generation Ah-chan, who performed as Center Nova at a performance and then hasn't been seen since.
Yep.
So this girl was the quote-unquote Center Nova position and then disappeared.
She just went fucking whoosh.
Yuko shows up and Suzuko asks her about it. And Yuko's like, yeah, there was a Center Nova and I'm going to be the next one. And you're like, okay. There's also a point where she's reading and she sees something about Sensei Sensei.
Yep.
And she's like, who's Sensei Sensei? And they're like, we're not allowed to talk about that.
We do not speak of it.
Well, every time we ask, we get shut down and you'll get in trouble if you look into this more. So that's some secret stuff you find out in this episode.
Idoluminati.
Because Idoluminati.
In space.
in space. Okay, and then other things that happen in this episode, you find out the reason why Sonata wanted to be an idol in the first place, and also why Kanata did, but also this is why Sonata left, even though she didn't pass the auditions, is that Kanata's dad, so red hair, spiky, one of the Unlucky Generation trainees, her dad, her and Sonata's dad, was a pro-entertainment, like, underground fighter, rebellion fighter, and he got killed by the DES in battle. And so they want to become members of AKB 0048 to avenge him.
Cool.
You know? Mm-hmm. Just idol anime things.
Yeah, just idol anime things.
So then all the girls, like, start doing their training. Basically, the new trainees join Mimori and Kanata. Like, there are other trainees in the AKB-verse, but Mimori and Kanata are kind of adopted into their new group. And they're training, and the dance instructor is, like, keeps chastising Kanata, being like, oh, you're not doing great enough, you gotta keep working hard, and, like, kind of puts Cherry as the center position. At some point, this turns into Kanata, like, kind of, like, feeling like, I'm never going to become an actual successor. And she, like, goes by the river and cries. But then Mimori comes up to her and starts singing the song that they had in their concert. And it's really sweet. Mm-hmm. And they're like, okay, we'll work really hard together and we'll become successors. And then, yeah, it's all happy. Mm-hmm. So there's that. Episode 5. My first notes for episode 5. So I think this is one of the ones where I switched to English. Makoto's English voice actor sounds a little bit like Kyokiko and Maguka Maduka. I told you we'd talk about Maguka. She's very like,
oh, Lord.
Yep.
Oh, no.
So it's basically this episode, there's not a lot of important things. It's more of a slice of lifey one. It's their day off. They're looking around. Some go to the spa. Some are training. There's some gags about wanting to, quote unquote, increase pheromones. But this episode, I think it is, yeah, it's Orine and Yuka, and they go around and they're like, oh, we're going to go visit one of the successors, Tomomi, and we're going to go to her family house, because I guess they give tours.
Mm-hmm.
And when they go to the family house, they find out, first of all, they notice that every single female looks like Tomomi. Like, they visually, they have a lot of things in common. They all have, like, the sad eyes and swoopy hair and kind of, like, W-E mouths, like, ooh-ooh mouths.
Like, kitty mouth.
And you find out that Tomomi's family has been essentially, like, breeding Tomomi successors for generations. And all of them learned to act like the original Tomomi and have the same personality and like the same foods and look the same way. And they even, like, hire or, like, they even, like, marry men who will have babies that look like Tomomi. So this is, like,
idol eugenics now.
Yeah. So that's that.
Yeah.
And you're like, okay, this is how the successor thing is working, huh?
Mm-hmm.
also at some point on their time out, Nagisa and Chieri, main characters, are talking. And Nagisa's like, I want to be a successor to Yuko one day. And then Cherry's like, you know, that means that Yuko has to graduate to do that because there can only be one. And
there can only be one.
Like, oh, shit. I don't want her to graduate because we met her and we like her. And she also saved our lives.
Mm-hmm. I don't want to take her place because she's cool.
So that conflict is also beginning of, oh, no, you have to take someone's place to become idol.
But here's the other thing. There are literally hundreds of AKB members. You don't have to replace anyone. You can just take someone else's name. There's so many to choose from.
That's the tension there. So you see, A, the creepy, like, bred to be a successor thing. And then also, like, oh, but to be a successor, you have to wait for someone to either, like, quit or, like, I assume die in combat.
Mm-hmm.
So... You know,
just idle anime things.
All right, episode 6. So all the girls are practicing, and then you find out that the trainees are going to have their first handshake event.
Yay.
And it's like, it's part of like a bigger AKB concert and handshake event. The trainees are not giving the concert. They're just doing handshakes.
Mm-hmm.
So they're all like, oh, we're going to learn how to interact with fans. Apparently, some of them already have some fans, just because of, like, a PV that went out earlier. And then Orine gets a letter. And it's from someone who saw the fan promo. And all the girls are so excited. And they're like, heck yeah. And then they load up the data chip. And it's a mysterious figure. And you don't see their eyes. And they're like, you don't have what it takes to be part of AKB. You should die.
Hate mail! Woo!
Yeah, so part of like the Nico text chain is in there.
The future Nico text chain in space.
It's Nico and Shiho and Shiho and this creepy person.
Yep.
So Orine is shaken up, right? Because she's like, we're about to have this handshake event, but someone just threatened my life.
Yep. What a cool and chill thing to do.
Yep. So the other girls kind of notice it's shaking up Orine. They talk to her about it. And then another character, a successor, we haven't mentioned her yet, but she is also very important, Takamina.
Yes.
So she has really weird hair. It's green, but she has like a chin-length haircut, but then also a ponytail that goes down to her butt.
It's very dumb. But you should still cosplay her because we have the same height difference as Yuko and Takamina.
I love her. She's great. And so she is named after Minami Takahashi, who was actually a longtime center of AKB. Like, she kept winning elections to be a center.
Mm-hmm.
And she's generally known as a lead, like, the actual Takamina, the real AKB Takamina.
Yep.
Is known as a leader. And they extrapolate that into this show, being the person who takes on the name Takamina is always the leader of AKB.
Yeah.
So she ends up talking to Orine about it and kind of uses her leadership abilities to give Orine confidence to do the handshake event. At the handshake event, Orine's like, with the encouragement from Takamina, is like, no, I'm going to push through. I'm going to go through the handshake event. It'll be great. When it's their turn, like, there's pretty much no one in line because they're still relatively unknown. But then a mom comes up with a little girl and they go straight to Orine and they're like, I'm your fan. We thought you were really cute in the PV. She really wants to shake your hand, like this little girl. And then Orine gets like so happy she starts crying.
Aw.
Yeah. And then, you know, there's like a montage of other fans trickling in. And then angry person comes up, the person who said the threatening death letter.
Mm-hmm. You'd think that he wouldn't be allowed in the tent.
Yup. You would think there'd be higher security, but you know. And like Cherry steps in and she's like, you can't talk to Orine. We'll stop you before you do anything bad to her. And he starts to like open his mouth to speak. And then there is an attack.
Oh no. Who could have seen that coming?
It's the DES. And then this is the point where I was like screaming at my TV. Because in addition to these idols, these unprepared idols, because they're just doing their handshake event, they don't have their mic sabers with them. They're like the idols like prioritize like saving the fans.
Mm-hmm.
And then like out of like the rafters, the WOTA show up,
yes,
and they have glow stick missiles
Yes.
The best part is they have like mechs similar to the DES mechs, but they're like Ida mechs because they have like the girls' like faces on them. Mm-hmm. And apparently, in this future situation, the Woda, they're like also soldiers, and they support their idols financially, but also with missiles.
Yep. If you're going to be a fan of me as an idol, I expect you to bring missiles to every concert in case it gets attacked.
Well, I mean, the glow sticks are missiles, so.
God, can you imagine? Okay, no, Sarah, I just had a vision, right? I just had a vision. Yes. So the way these glow sticks work is they, like, fire the glowy part off when you aim, right? Like a Roman candle. Imagine you're at a concert. You're off duty. You accidentally press the missile button.
Oh, no!
Like, you're just cheering, you're, like, woting, and you're like, hey, hi, oh, fuck!
Oh, fuck!
It just fires into the ceiling and just destroys this concert hall.
Yup, so the Woda and DES are fighting in the background, all the other girls are saving people. There's a part where Orine's hater is about to get attacked, but Orine saves him, and then mentions, like, you are not my fan, but you're important too because you're my first hater.
Don't give him that.
Right?
Don't give him that encouragement.
And then you find out it's because the person she wants to succeed, he's a big fan of, or was a big fan of, because this person already graduated. But she's like, I also love Sashiko, the person who graduated, and we have a lot in common, even though you're my hater, blah, 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 blah. So later on, after the attack, Orina gets another fan mail, and it's from the hater, and it's basically like, you have a lot to do to live up to Sashiko, but I don't hate you anymore. The end.
The end.
But this is important because you find out about the Woda. They're amazing.
The Woda War Squadron.
It's just Edomex. Like, I love that. Like, that's the part that made me scream, is they just have Edomex.
Absolutely incredible. For anyone who might not know what we're talking about, I need you to imagine, like, those, like, they call them Itasha, that where they're, like, the cars with, like, the anime characters' faces emblazoned on them. You can see them at, like, anime conventions occasionally.
Mm-hmm.
But it's that, but a mech.
Yep.
Like a Gundam covered in anime girl faces.
Yep. It's incredible. I mean, love it.
To be fair, though, if you're going to spend all this money on a mech, you might as well make it cute.
Absolutely. Like, I'm just so pleased.
I feel like Code Geass, the one mecha show that I'm actively familiar with, would be extremely improved if all of the nightmare frames were covered in cute anime girls. I think that would have greatly improved the show as a whole.
And also, I just appreciate whoever decided, like, in this anime production, like, no, we're not just going to give them mechs. Because, like, it's just so good. It's just so good.
Well, I mean, we have to differentiate between the evil mechs and the idol mechs somehow. Mm-hmm. So what are we going to do? Rather than just, you know, make the idol mechs, like, slightly different shapes, fuck that.
Yep.
Cover them in idols.
So, episode 7. So you find out new news for AKB0048, because there's new news every episode.
News!
That they are bringing back the understudy program.
Ooh, what's the understudy program?
It's essentially the same thing as being an understudy for, like, any sort of, like, theatrical thing, where they're going to choose some girls who are going to basically learn alongside the successors. So if for whatever reason the successors can't perform at a performance, the understudies know all the song and dance.
Yep.
And the reason why they're bringing it back is that three of the girls, one of them is Takamina, so she's important. The other one's Yuko, and the other one I'm not going to mention because there's too many girls.
Yep, too many girls.
The three of them are doing a, like, some sort of, like, rescue concert on another planet, so they won't be able to join this concert, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so they announce the understudies, and one of them is Kanata.
Red hair.
Good girl. She is Takamina's understudy. Memori is another understudy, so she's the other one from Kanata's generation.
Mm-hmm.
Then Chieri is Yuko's understudy, which is like some drama because Nagisa wanted to succeed Yuko one day.
Mm-hmm.
And actually there was four girls. And then another girl we're not going to mention, her understudy is another new girl named Megumi.
I do not remember this character.
She is from the same generation as, like, Yuko. So the generation before Kanata. She has, like, brownish hair.
She's not in the lineup, therefore I don't remember who she is.
That's fair enough. She has, like, brown hair, and it's, like, in, like, bows that, like, cover, like, around her neck and, like, curly underneath. So, yes, she comes up a bit.
I feel like some of these characters might just be, like, internally referential to AKB. I feel like of the stuff is, but something to note is that Sarah, well, I won't speak for Sarah, but I know personally, I don't know shit about AKB except for, like, some of the songs.
Yep.
And what you can learn from watching the show.
Yep.
So.
I do not know much about AKB. We are so sorry. 2D idols. But, so Megumi is the other new character. So she is from a generation prior to Momori and Kanata. So she's two generations back.
Mm-hmm.
She's not a successor, but some of, like, her colleagues that she, like, was a trainee with became successors.
Okay.
All right. So Kanata, Momori, Chieri, and new girl Megumi, they're all understudies, right?
Mm-hmm.
Apparently this idea was also sponsored by the voice in the darkness, who we now know is named Sensei Sensei.
Yep.
Tsubasa realizes that Sensei Sensei has been acting weird.
Mm-hmm.
Tsubasa is sometimes one of the shrine people. And apparently Sensei Sensei has been composing lyrics, quote, in response to them, unquote.
You just said several words.
Yep. So that's going on. While the understudies are practicing, the other girls get some time off. During this time off, Nagisa ends up, like, kind of following Chieri around at practice. They have, like, a little heart-to-heart on, like, what it means to be a successor and, like, not taking each other's place and encouraging each other. And they're a good ship. So, mentioning that. Other interactions, though, is Takamina and Kanata are doing well together. Like, Kanata is doing great following Takamina's dances. Kanata, I should also note, was kind of put in charge of the trainees. Like, she's kind of the trainees' leader. So they both have, like, these leader vibes.
Mm-hmm.
Takamina is, like, proud of Kanata and is like, you know, one day you're going to be a great successor. I'm so proud of you. I'm really glad you're my understudy, right?
Mm-hmm.
You also get a section where you find out that Chieri, she was like, you know, you knew before she was some CEO's daughter.
Mm-hmm.
But apparently her dad actually designs these DES attack robots.
Ooh, so, scandalous.
Scandalous. Essentially, Chieri, she gets confronted about her dad designing these soldiers for the DES, which, I mean, fair.
Yeah.
She gets really emotional about it, and basically she doesn't show up to practice with the other understudies the next day.
Uh-oh.
Just like, oh, drama. In the middle of practice, the other girls are like, I don't know what to do. But then Kanata's like, we're going to stop practice and I'm going to go find her. And Kanata runs off, right?
Mm-hmm.
Essentially, Kanata does end up finding Chieri. They have a little bit of a heart-to-heart about, well, you know, like, Kanata's dad got killed by DS soldiers, and then Chieri's dad, like, created these mech suits that might have killed Kanata's dad.
Yeah, it's a whole thing.
Yeah, it's dark, right? They kind of talk about how both of them are following their dreams, like, not because of their parents, but because of themselves. And that they're not their fathers, and they, like, cry and hug. So Kanata's, like, reassures Chieri and, like, kind of shows her own, like, willingness to, like, go out and, like, help someone else in the middle of this practice, right?
Yeah.
So at the same time, Kanata leaves the audition. Takamina observes Kanata leaving, and she's like, wow, Kanata, she cares so much. She's been really, really good as a practice as an understudy. I think she's good enough to be a successor. I'm not sure why they haven't named her to be a successor yet, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then she talks to these other girls, and they're like, yeah, I don't know how they actually choose successors either. So she and a group of other girls, so Takamina, Yuko, and then two other girls who I'm not going to mention because it'll just get confusing, they all follow Tsubasa, right? Because they're on this... the AKB Akiba Star planet. They all follow Tsubasa.
Mm-hmm.
And they end up at a place with Tori Gates and a mysterious figure and a cave. So they're like, okay,
cool.
This is the Sensei Sensei place, but also there's this cave. So they walk inside the cave, and it's like a giant, like, underground bamboo forest thing, and, like, there's water puddles and a cave. And the cave is full of Kirara. Like, all the little floaty alien things.
Mm.
And then the Kiyoraras start changing and they morph into like these disc things. And they start showing images of original AKB48 members, anime versions of the real life girls who exist. And so basically it would show like the original member and then like the original Yuko, and then it would like switch to Yuko that we know. And so it would go one by one. And then the one for the original Takamina, it just shows like the current Takamina and not the original Takamina. And then there's another one that shows the original Takamina, and then it switches. But instead of switching to Takamina, it switches to Kanata.
Oh no!
And Takamina's like, what the fuck is this? Why is it not showing me with the original Takamina? Why is Kanata showing up? What does this mean? And then Tsubasa runs in and she's like, you girls are not supposed to see this. It's like forbidden.
Forbidden!
And Takamina's like, yo, tell us what the fuck is going on right now. And you find out that these are the Kiraras of Succession. And basically what they do is they reflect the original soul of the AKB48 girls. And they show the person in the universe who has the closest soul to them.
Okay.
And this means that at this point in time, the person who is closest to the original Takamina is not current Takamina, but actually Kanata. And it's been like that for a little bit ever since Kanata became a leader of the trainees.
Oh, shit. Coming for your gig.
Yeah. And also Takamina's like shocked, right? Because she's like, what the fuck? Does that mean I'm not actually supposed to be Takamina? And also, does that mean that Kanata won't become a successor until I graduate, thus meaning I'm the one in the way of making Kanata become a successor, which it sucks because she also recently became friends with Kanata. So she's like, what am I supposed to do now?
Yeah, I just remember that this plot was like really fucked because it's
really
like
fucked up.
You feel bad for everyone.
Yeah.
And it's like, oh God. Because like, of course, like Takamina, current Takamina, she doesn't want to graduate yet. She's like at her high point.
Yep.
But also Kanata's been like fucking working and struggling, and like, what do you do when you are the person who is actively standing in the way of your friend's happiness and they don't even know about it? Do you tell them? Are you honest with them? What do you do? It's fucked.
Yep. So Yuko starts like calling out Tsubasa, being like, basically saying like, yo, this is really fucked up, and Takamina is always going to be our Takamina, and fuck you all, and leaves. So Yuko's pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, that's what you find out at the end of that episode. Episode 8, it is concert day.
Ta-da!
And all the understudies perform, and they do good, and they've definitely been learning. And the thing that's important is while the main concert is going on, all the other trainees, like, in the back of the theater are, like, dancing along to the song and, like, lip-syncing.
Mm-hmm.
And the instructor notes to Tsubasa that, like, we couldn't keep these girls out of the practice room. They insisted on watching the whole time. And apparently you find out that this set of trainees is, like, really, really gung-ho about giving performances.
Mm-hmm.
So then after the understudy concert, all the four girls who were, like, the original, including Takamina and Yuko, they come back from their, like, idol mission. Kanata runs up to Takamina, and she's like, oh, I did so good. And it's important to note that Takamina's just like, I'm proud of you, but she doesn't say anything about what she learned.
Yeah.
So they're like, we're just not going to deal with this right now because I don't know how to.
Yep.
Then Tsubasa announces that they are going to have a new concert, another concert. AKB0048 is having another concert on a planet called Tundra Star, which actually really has a full entertainment band. It's not just the test, like actual full entertainment band. But the fans need them because it's a full entertainment band and these people are sad and they need idols. For backup for AKB, because they know there will be a DES attack because there's a full band, they are going to invite the trainees that we met, and then also Kanata Memori and Megu. So, like, the new generation, Kanata Memori, and Megu, the other future understudy. Mm-hmm. And that group of girls will be backup for main AKB. There is a point here where Megu is upset that, like, other members of her generation, those trainees aren't joining. But Tsubasa's like, yo, the new trainees were practicing the whole time while you're doing the concert, so it's them before your generation. So it kind of is showing, like, it's not seniority what's going on here.
It's who works hardest.
It's who works hardest. At this point, there's a bit of a conflict between Megu and the other trainees. This eventually does get resolved, but that's where Megu becomes important, and that's why I introduced her as a character. There's so many girls.
I don't remember her at all.
Yeah. And part of her other conflict is, I guess, her best friend from her generation became a successor. And so, like, whenever she meets her former best friend, she, like, talks to her by, like, her actual birth name and not by her successor name, and the person's like, no, I'm Sae now, and you're like, this is so weird.
It's like, it's not even a stage name, it's like you have to be that person at all times.
Yep, you are that person. Meanwhile, with this concert, Tsubasa is getting intel from the Woda on the ground, because that's how it works.
Yep.
And they're like, well, maybe we will pull out and not actually do this concert because the DES is like all over the city where we're performing. But then Takamina, thinking about how much she actually has to act like a leader and perform and how her time might be limited, is like, no, we're giving this performance no matter what. Mm-hmm. And then Candace is like, heck yeah, Takamina, you're the best leader. Your decisions are right. I agree. Trainees, let's go with her and back her up. And then Takamina is like, heck, Candace is doing even better at being a leader than me again.
No, she's going to take my job.
Takamina is having this conflict when their ship starts getting attacked by DES soldiers en route to Tundra Star. The main AKB girls go out in their mechs to go fight DES. But while she's fighting, Takamina is like super distracted because she's thinking of all the like fucked up shit she learned about, you know, AKB and idols in general. Mm-hmm. So Kanata like grabs her own mech and volunteers as backup because Takamina is not doing well. But then Takamina's mech explodes. And Takamina is injected into space.
Pachoo!
And as she starts fading, she's like, the Kirara's chose Kanata.
So I can die now.
Someone like rescues Takamina and they're like, Takamina, are you okay? And her like words before she like faints are like, that isn't my name. And you're like, oh my god.
She's having a crisis of identity that she's of a person that she is who was born and died thousands of years ago.
So Takamina survives. She's in like the recovery bay. Yuko starts talking to her because they're besties. And she's like, I don't want you to quit. I want you to continue being Takamina. And I know that you have guilt for this, but like, I know you feel like you're holding back Kanata's dream, but in the weird fucked up way, it's also sacrificing your own dream. And you are not worth less than another person. So it's like, oof.
No matter how badly that person is better suited for your job.
So they talk about how, like, despite this, this is from what now that what they learned, that they know that that's just going to be the case, right? Like, until they graduate, nobody could be that person, and that's just how it is. And even though before they didn't know that a specific person had a specific role, they still had the whole general feeling that they had a limited spot, right?
Mm-hmm.
Meanwhile, though, Kanata is like, all like, I wasn't able to save Takamina. I have to do more. I have to become even more of a leader to save Takamina. And you're like, oh no. So that's going on. Episode 9. They are on the ground at Tundra Star, and the Woda are doing what they can do, but the DS is amping up forces. Takamina is injured from her attack, so Tsubasa's like, Takamina, you can't perform, we'll get Kanata to take your place. And Takamina's like, no, I can perform, but like, you know, when she tries to stand up, she like falls. There's a little bit where Megu talks to the girl she was friends with, and they decide that they're going to be close and they're going to help each other in combat. So that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
And then the trainees, all the girls, they are, while everyone else is like practicing for the main concert, they decide, hey, nothing else is happening. We're going to go do some quote unquote reconnaissance, aka play in the snow at Tundra Star. So they go play around and then they spot a town. And the town is, like, super sad. Like, it's run down. Like, everyone's, like, in line at a soup line in the cold. And there's all, like, these no idol signs everywhere. And they're like, oh, this is because they don't allow idols.
Yeah, that's why you're poor.
I think there might be other reasons, but okay.
No, it's because of the lack of idols.
And so the girls are like, no, we have to give an idol concert and we have to inspire this town no matter what. We have to let AKB perform because otherwise they will be sad like this forever. Cherry is like, well, on the other hand, if we give a concert and we just leave, it's like we're giving them dreams and just like ripping them away right away.
Yep.
Just like, yeah. But in the distance, they hear the AKB song Heavy Rotation and they're like, oh, what is that? And then there are some girls in an igloo, and they are watching and performing an AKB song.
In an igloo!
And they're like, oh, wait, are you the trainees for AKB? I'm so glad you're here. You changed my life. This is a dream. This is like the only happiness we have in our lives. And they're like, okay, yeah, we'll do the performance. So they give like a little tiny performance for these girls, and then Tsubasa is observing from afar, and there's like a point where like the DES sees them doing this little gorilla live. Tsubasa saves them, but then Tsubasa's like, hey, what you just did, that's our new plan of attack. You girls, the trainees, are going to give a gorilla live concert in this small town to distract the DES from the main concert in the bigger venue.
This'll totally work.
That night, the townspeople are in their sad small town. And then all of these, like, heart-shaped spotlights start going around. And then these girls appear, like, out of nowhere, like, on the rooftops and in random alleys. And they start singing.
Mm-hmm.
The DS were, like, completely unprepared for this literal gorilla live because they also start attacking back. And, yeah, so there's, like, they, like, cause avalanches to take down DES. They're still singing their cutesy little song and there's gunfire. This is like how all the concerts are. It's like there's these cutesy songs about like love or friendship, and then it's like in the background. Yep, that's going on. Essentially, this works. They have their concert. And then because of this, the main successors were able to set up the venue okay and are about to go on stage. And Kanata is in the back. She's about to put on Takamina's uniform because Takamina can't perform. And then Takamina bursts into the dressing room and she's like, give me back my outfit. And then Kanata's like, but then like a Kirara comes up to Takamina and starts glowing. And you're like, oh, is this mean Takamina's taken back leadership in the struggle? And Kanata's like, here you go. So Kanata kind of looks sad, and the other girls are like, well, that's kind of shitty for you to do, but yeah, okay.
Yeah, it really is, actually.
Yeah. But Takamina goes on stage and starts performing, and Kanata's like, I'll just be your backup. So she puts on the military uniform, and then AKB starts performing, the main group of successors. Kanata's kind of looking on, tearing up in her mech, but she's like, yeah, Takamina is the best, and she's the real center, and I'm so proud, and I hope one day I can become like Takamina. And you're like, oh.
Hurts no. So bad, because I love Kanata so much.
I know.
And she's just getting screwed over by this arrangement.
Yep.
So much.
So Takamina, she's still, like, you know, not feeling good, because she got exploded. She falls down at some point, but Yuko catches her. But essentially, it kind of is like she can't do more than the first song.
Mm-hmm.
Kanata, like, rescues Takamina. The DES are rolling in. All this is going on. And then at the end, so, like, all like this main concert is going on, right? And then the trainees, they stumble upon, like, an area that reminded, like, Nagisa and Orini and stuff of, like, their home in Lancaster. And then they start, like, singing, like, a little song, like, kind of a cappella, but there's background music, about, like, having friends to support their dreams and not being alone. How the four of them were, like, inspired to join AKB because of a similar thing to what they're doing on Tundra Star, and how it changed their life, and how they're making these people's dreams come true in this small town and also this planet. And then, like, while they're singing this cute little song and having these inner monologues, a bunch of Kiraras start showing up. And also, like, all the townspeople are watching their attack because I guess the DES thing is at the main concert now and not at the small town.
Mm-hmm.
And the Kiraras light up and you're like, oh, they have the idol senses are tingling.
It's idol time, baby.
It's idol time.
The jellyfish say so.
And then back at the main concert, after Takamina collapses, Kanata picks her up. And Kanata kind of just, like, says to Takamina while Takamina is, like, sick and sad and, like, sitting in her lap. She's like, I don't deserve to wear your clothes yet, but someday I'll catch up to you. And poor Takamina's like, oh, I fucked up. Also, this whole thing is awful.
Oh, I fucked up.
But also at this point, I'm like, I really like the Takamina Kanata ship. Right? Like, it's great.
Oh, God, of course you do.
It's a good one. Like, I know there's the Takamina Yuko and Kanata Memori or whatever, but Takamina and Kanata, it's a good ship. It's a good one. I like it. It's my ship. My brand.
My brand.
My brand. So, episode 10. There is all this conflict going on because of this really weird system that they decided to adopt for their idols in space.
Mm-hmm.
And in the opening scene, Tsubasa is at Sensei Shrine and talks about how the concert was successful thanks to the new recruits. And then Sensei starts glowing, like the light from the darkness. A bunch of Kiraras come out, and then Tsubasa internal monologues like, has the time come finally? Dun dun dun.
Dun dun dun.
And then they're all at the beach. And you're like, wow, last episode was really dark with the Takamina Kanata and stuff. And now they're at the beach. Okay.
Yep. Sarah, we can't have an idol show without a beach episode. Come
yes,
on.
It's true. This episode, it's mostly like beach gags. There's a lot of body issue stuff with Makoto. So not really going to go into that because it's kind of gross.
Moving on.
Yeah, just moving on with that. Some small things you find out that Suzuko actually does not want to be a member of AKB in the end. She actually wants to do something like Tsubasa and be part of the administration. And you're like, okay, that's valid. Kind of weird that you feel like you have to be an idol to do that first. But then there's also a point where Yuko walks up to Tsubasa and Tsubasa's just kind of lounging on this beach. And so Yuko's like, oh, hey, this is the location I had my first gravure shot. Isn't that right, seventh generation Mariko? And then Tsubasa's dun, hand dun, twitches, dun. And you're like, oh, Tsubasa used to be an idol.
Ooh.
And then, like, Yuko uses this, like, leg up to be like, tell me about what's going on in that cave. What are your plans? What's going on? What the fuck?
Tell me about the cave.
And then Tsubasa's like, don't worry about it. It'll be okay. Takamina is still going to be the center until she decides to graduate. It doesn't really matter what the Kiraras say. It's her choice to stay or not. But then Yuko's like, you know, actually, in addition to that, though, I want to know if my own dream's possible. I want to be Center Nova. I remember Center Nova is a thing that happened a long time ago, and you found out some girl disappeared and they stopped doing it.
Mm-hmm.
And then you find out also that Tsubasa, the generation she was part of, was the same generation with the last Center Nova, Achan, who disappeared. Mm-hmm. And so basically Tsubasa admits the relationship and then says that she was, quote, next to Achan when it happened. And then there's a flashback to a very bright light and this girl disappearing in the middle of a concert. And then you're like, yep. Oh, they don't mean disappeared like she ran away. They mean disappeared like she disappeared.
Yeah, she just fucking vanished off the stage.
And apparently, this is something that's been happening to every single Center Nova ever.
Yep.
So Tsubasa's like, there will never be another Center Nova. And Yuko's like, but I want to be Center Nova. And you're like, Yuko, why? Yeah, Yuko even says, like, I don't care if I disappear as long as I become Center Nova. And you're like, oh. So that's going on. Also going on, Nagisa and Chieri and the others are all having, like, a photo shoot, right, in their bikinis. And the photographer is like giving very specific instructions. And at some point, Nagisa and Chieri are having a photo shoot together. And the photographer's like, no, get closer, no, get closer, no, get closer, until they're like on top of each other. And then when they do, like, the curare that follows Chieri around, like, starts glowing really, really bright. And the photographer takes a picture of them in this moment. It's like not a flattering picture of them, but the bright curare. And the photographer's like, yes, got it. And you're like, cool, she's in on something.
Ooh.
Ooh. So later on that night, Nagisa and Chieri have a conversation about, like, their own feeling that the other person is better because of the relationship with the curare, and how someone, like, it followed Chieri, but it lights up for Nagisa. And then they're like, well, but maybe it's something else entirely. We don't know yet. Dun, dun, dun.
Dun, dun, dun.
Also that night, Tsubasa is at the bar in the hotel, and then the camera person shows up. And you find out that this camera person was also an idol and also the same generation as Tsubasa. And
everybody's an idol.
Everyone's an idol. And also this person used to be a candidate for Center Nova, but ran away before anything bad happened.
Because she was like, all the Center Novas keep disappearing. I'm out.
Right? And so the photographer hands them over the picture of the curare and is like, it's like, here, this is what you wanted, right? And then she also says, if you bring back the Center Nova position, I will do everything in my power to stop you. And you're like, this is extreme.
Yeah. But I mean, like, okay, so think about it.
Yep.
What is the benefit to the Center Nova position?
I don't know.
Because it seems like it's all cons.
Right?
People would know that the Center Novas keep disappearing.
Yep.
Why would they want the Center Nova position back?
Yep.
If, like, yeah, okay, so sure, Center Nova, whatever. There's a precedent for them to just fuck it up and vanish in the middle of concerts. Why yep. do you want your idols to disappear?
It's not good, no. Episode 11. So you find out all this, like, happy stuff. Again, the rest of the episode is, like, just, like, anime-type gags. Like, oh, my boobs are big enough.
Hijinks.
But then there's also, like, these people are disappearing.
And we don't know where they're going. They might be dead. You don't know.
Yep. So that contrast happens in that episode. This is a wild show. Episode 11. They are scheduled to have a new concert, and it's on Lancaster. And this is the planet where Orine, Tsubasa, Yuka, and Nagisa all saw the concert. It's where three of them grew up. And in addition to the AKB's concert, the trainees are going to have their debut concert as a group.
Ooh, boy.
And also, I would like to note that the way this is announced is, like, AKB, like, the successors are having a concert, like, on, like, their theater in Akihabara. And then, like, an alert comes up, and it's like, alert, new concert on Lancaster, trainees are performing. And then all the successors are like, what? And then Tsubasa's like, what? And you're like, no one knows this.
No one knew about it. Because a spooky voice in a cave makes all their business decisions. Like, and their marketing, apparently.
It's like the wall got extreme and learned how to use computers.
Or something.
Or something. The trainees are excited about this because this means that they're technically going to be in a concert at the same time as the successors, which is, like, pretty wild. And then Tsubasa announces some of the songs they're singing. And one of the songs that they have been sent to sing is called Nagisa no Cherry. And you're like, oh, okay. That's where they got the names from. And in the past, it's always been sung by a Center Nova. And it's also a solo song. Like, there's a big solo in it.
Mm-hmm.
And Tsubasa gives this role to Nagisa.
Ooh!
So Nagisa's like, no, wait, wait, I don't deserve it. I'm not a strong singer. And Tsubasa's like, no, you're singing this song. You're like, oh, there's some drama there. Also, Yuka gets an email from her ex-boyfriend. And he's like, don't come back to Lancaster. I don't want to see you. And Yuka's like, what the fuck?
Shit.
I haven't heard from you for a year, and this is what you send me. All right.
Rude.
Nagisa, during practice, is struggling with the song. And she's just, like, not doing great. And she's like, I don't know why they gave me this song, right? But then later, it's kind of implied that it's because of the glowing cure aura and something. So put that on a bookshelf because they talk about it more later. And then there's a lot of just this happens in this episode. And then you also find out from Yuko coming in and confronting Tsubasa that Sensei has put out a new song specifically for the trainees to sing. And the reason why that's weird is this is the first time since Achan disappeared, the former Center Nova, that Sensei has ever put out a new song.
Yeah, how many years has it been?
Yeah, no, I don't know. Tsubasa is an adult now, and this is when she was a teen. So at least like 6, if not more. And then like on top of that, like you think about it and they're like also mentioning that these are all like the AKB songs they've been singing. They're like AKB songs that exist in 2012. So like,
yeah,
they've been singing the same songs for like centuries.
Yeah, it almost reminds me of that one Unraveled where it's like the music of Fallout. Yep. And they're like, are you telling me that they haven't made any new music in thousands of years or whatever?
Yup.
How are they still, like, good? How are people not tired of these these songs by now?
In some ways, too, it's like, at this point, like, is it just, like, cutesy songs? Or, like, when you think about the temple and the Kiraras and Sensei? Okay, Star, I would like to talk to you about ways people define cults.
Okay.
So, part of it is a charismatic leader. You have sensei, right? This is a little suspicious. Giving everyone a cohesive uniform.
Mm-hmm. Also applies to 22-7.
Cutting off contact with friends and family.
Yep, take them to another planet.
Giving them new names.
Oh, good.
Yeah. I don't know if this is an idol group, Star. I think this is a cult.
I think we have our second idol cult.
I think we have, and it's...
Well, okay, is it technically the third? Because if the I-1 cult is an I-1 cult, then yeah.
I think I-1 cult's an I-1 cult, so this is our third.
Number 3, charming.
And it has its own religion. It is banned, like government is like, no, do not come here. Like, they're putting their people out on the front lines and not giving them any, like, knowledge of why. They're not telling them why they're going places. Again, they are taking away people's personalities and names.
Holy shit.
This is a destructive cult.
Yeah, I feel like I sometimes put out hints for new episodes. I feel like the hint for this episode just needs to be like a bunch of pictures of like war and religious cults and politics. And then at the bottom, like in parentheses, but make it cute though.
But make it cute though. Yeah, so that's my theory on AKB, is it is a destructive cult.
Oh boy.
Yes. And that's why they're singing the same songs, is it's like, it's not idol music, it's a religion at this point.
Oh shit.
Right?
Pew, 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 Illuminati. This is what happens, Sarah. AKB0048 is the bad timeline.
Oh, no.
Where the Illuminati does not get exposed before humans take to space.
Oh no, you're right. When the wall becomes too powerful.
Oh god, and then the wall shoots itself into space and takes over the world.
Oh my god. So, yeah. Yep. Wow. And then also, like, I could see AKB0048 becoming a predecessor to Idol Project. Because you remember that episode where everyone turns into the girl?
Oh no!
I'm just saying. Anyways.
Anyway.
Back to that. Yuko, she's all upset that there's this new song for the first time in decades or whatever, and the successors don't get to sing it, the trainees do. So Tsubasa's like, no, it was written for the trainees, you can't have it. But Yuko practices anyways on her own. Some of her other members are like, hey, Yuko, what are you doing? You're not acting like yourself. And Yuko responds, quote, am I not acting like myself? Or am I not acting like ninth generation Yuko? And you're like, oh, this is just digging in the these are not themselves thing.
Yep. Yep. It's kind of fucked when you put more thought into it.
Yep. Meanwhile, Nagisa is still struggling at practice. And Chiari's like, you're singing a solo. and your work is unexcusable. If you don't do good enough, they're going to take this away from you. But anyways, Tsubasa gets a message from Lancaster, because that's where the big concert is and where all the girls came from. And apparently, their concert was leaked to the DES, and the DES are going to be sending in troops to the concert. So things are getting a little bit more high tension.
Uh-oh.
And also, apparently on Lancaster, since the girls left about a year ago, there's been a very intense anti-entertainment movement going on. Yuka, blonde hair, pigtails, is like, I wonder if this is why my ex told me not to come back. And you're like, oh.
Not just because he's a dick, but because all the idol girls gonna die.
So, meanwhile, the girls land on Lancaster, and everything is definitely more grim than when they left it. Again, it's not just an anti-industry town. There are now, again, once again, more blatant anti-entertainment things everywhere.
Mm.
The three who are originally from Lancaster walk around to see what changed. They find out that the school that Nagisa and Yuka went to is shut down. And then they're like, all like, oh, I wonder why the school shut down. And then Yuka's ex shows up and he has a gun.
Oh, no. Is he in the evil squad?
I wrote down like it's like the heckin' Sound of Music. But no, you find out actually that he is an underground fighter, an underground pro idol fighter, because things got more intense. And ever since Yuka left, he's been following AKB48. And then Yuka's like, oh, does that mean you're my fan? And he's like, no, I'm a Suzuko fan. And
she's
oh, fuck you. So the school apparently is now the new base of operations for this pro-entertainment movement that is fighting against the anti-entertainment movement that's been going on. It's the base of the WOTA.
The WOTA base?
Yes, the WOTA base. The leader of this underground movement of WOTA is a Kanata fan. Because not only does he like Kanata as a person, he also, like, used to fight alongside Kanata's dad. You're like, what's... I mean, yes, that's a good reason to be a stan for someone, I guess. Yeah, there's a DES attack. They run out. The thing that happens that's relatively important is during the attack, Orine sees one of the attack mechs has the etched in Sakura word. Mm-hmm. And she's like, oh no, this whole time I was making these mechs and I didn't know it.
Oh, like, oh shit.
Sorry. episode 12. It actually starts off mid-attack. All the girls run away. Orine ends up alone with Chieri and she's like talking about how she didn't realize she was doing this the whole time. Chieri starts blaming herself for her father. But then they both take out their mic sabers and they're like, we are going to destroy what we built. And you're like, good job.
Jeez. This fucking show.
Yup. But then the girls end up escaping. This is when it's revealed that the person who's the leader, who is a Kanata stan, also fought alongside Kanata's father. But then you also find out that Nagisa's father, remember he worked at the Entertainment Bureau?
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, ever since Nagisa left and joined AKB, he's been in jail.
Oh, God.
And he is imprisoned in a place that is in the mines, the same place where they saw the first concert.
Mm-hmm.
And Nagisa's like, I have to rescue my father. And you're like, yeah. So...
Well, okay. If she breaks him out of jail, where is he gonna go? Is he gonna come back to the idol planet?
I don't know. So, I mean, that would make sense, right? So they go to rescue him. The WOTA, like, back her up. The girls infiltrate this prison.
Prison break.
Like, to the point where, like, Megu, like, is helping them out, right? The girl who used to hate them, but now is friends. She gets shot.
Of course.
Later on, you find out that she can't do the concert because she was injured from this rescue mission.
She got shot.
F. Nagisa ends up finding her dad in the prison, and then he refuses to leave. He's like, it's daughter, you became AKB, but you abandoned this planet because you're like, wow, horrible dad. And I can't leave this prison because I was a support of entertainment. And if I turn my back on Lancaster, it will never be saved. I'm staying in this prison until the politics change. Oh, and you're boy. Like, wow. Okay. Political intrigue.
Cool statement, dude.
And basically, Nagisa is, like, completely, like, what the fuck? Like, in her head at this point, she's like, I caused all of this to happen. Like, caused her dad to be imprisoned and this planet to turn into an anti-idol planet.
Mm-hmm.
So basically they all retreat. They go to Yuka's parents' house, which apparently is, like, a, like, izakaya. And they, like, have been feeding the Woda or whatever. But Nagisa, like, even while the others are, like, a little bit more upbeat because they have, like, the Woda there to support them, Nagisa is, like, completely shell-shocked, right?
Mm-hmm.
She drives by her former house and notices, like, the garden has been completely, like, grown over. And apparently the garden was her mom's pride and joy. So she's like, oh, no, my mom's not doing well. My dad's in prison. Our planet is suffering.
Being idle is suffering.
And then at practice, it's her turn to sing Nagisa no Cherry. And she goes up to sing, and she has lost her voice. Yep. So Cherry's like, I'll step in for Nagisa because there's no way she can do this. And Nagisa is, like, kind of sad and conflicted, but she's also kind of like, yeah, I can't sing right now.
She's too heartbroken. Her doki doki is brokey brokey, Sarah.
Meanwhile, drama in the same place on this on their ship. Yuko is still practicing the new song that was only given to the trainees. Takamina joins in with her, so she's also practicing in secret together.
Mm-hmm.
Yugo's like, I hate this new song, how it's only about the new generation. And then Takamina, like, collapses. And you're like, uh-oh. And then she says that she's still suffering from her injury when her ship exploded. But at the same time, quote, I'm taking medicine to stop the pain. So.
Hmm.
Yeah. And then Takamina's like, after that and all the things that happen, I think I am going to graduate after this concert. I think I'm going to step down and let Kana to take my place.
Oh, shit.
But you could tell that she's still conflicted about it. But she's like, after everything that happened, I can't do it anymore, right?
Mm-hmm. I can't do it anymore, man.
Meanwhile, back with Nagisa and Cherry, Cherry notices Nagisa still being down after practice and is like, don't tell me you're thinking about graduating. She's like, no, you cannot graduate because we need to be on the same stage together and you can't even think about graduating until we dance and sing together for Nagisa no Cherry. Because, I mean, it's basically named after them. And then she says, I will never lose to you. Which, again, kind of harkens back to the beginning where it's like, is it a competition or are we friends or is it both? And then Nagisa, it kind of stirs Nagisa. So instead of having, like, dead eyes, she's, like, a little bit sparkly.
Mm-hmm. She gets the sparkle back.
And then it is time for the trainee concert. Right before the concert, Yuka thanks her ex, talks about how different things are now. The ex is kind of like, I love you as a member of 00, but I wouldn't love you if you weren't in the group. And you're like, what the fuck?
Shit. Okay.
What an asshole. Anyways, they give a cheer. They go on stage. They do their first song, which is Ogoe Diamond, I think. Mm-hmm. The Woda and, like, the defense idol team are guarding the stage from the DES, so you start seeing the idol concert, but you hear, like, gunfire from behind.
These concerts must be just so extremely dangerous for the people attending.
Right?
Like, shit.
Yeah. And then a giant DES attack ship flies in. And the attack is, like, even worse than normal on these anti-idol planets. the Yuka's ex is, like, on the ground firing his gun, like, after he said this thing to Yuka, and he has, like, this, you know, like, those old-timey, like, war things where the guy has, like, a picture of his girl, like, on a flip book.
Oh, no.
But it's, like, a picture of Suzuko.
Yeah.
And he's, like, firing his gun. He's looking at this picture, like, I'm doing it for you. But then he flips up the picture, and underneath is a picture of Yuka.
Oh!
And you're like, what is this? But then mid-concert, Tsubasa gives everyone the order to retreat. Yuko kind of says goodbye to her ex while he's firing on the ground.
Mm-hmm.
And then as she leaves, she starts glowing, and then there's a new Kirara, and they're like, oh, a new idol's born.
An idol is born.
So the girls are retreating after only one song in the concert. There's gunfire everywhere. Yuka is now also fancy idol glowy like Cherry and Nagisa and the successors. And then episode 13, the last episode of the season, starts in the middle of this concert slash gunfire. The ship is retreating. The girls are back inside. Tsubasa's like, I'm canceling the concert. It's not safe. All the girls protest. Yuka's like, if we leave now, we might not ever be able to come back. And it's going to be worse than before. Nagisa starts thinking about how she's never going to see her parents again and her dad might die. Which, yeah. Tsubasa is thinking back and remembering, like, Achan, the center Nova she was idol friends with, who disappeared. And she's like, what would Achan do in this situation, right? So, then, like, all the girls are talking about how much they want to be idols again and how much they want to give the concert. And then, like, all of them are talking separately, all the trainees. And then Achan's voice, out of nowhere, just is like, let's do this concert again. Let's deliver it to everyone. Let's show everyone what idols are about. And Tsubasa's like, Achan? And then there's this glow, and the ship is filled with Kiraras. And there's a rainbow beam that comes from the ship and lights down on Lancaster.
Mm-hmm.
Back on the ground, the photographer girl who took their photos and used to be a member of AKB sees this light and is like, hey, fans, if you want to see the concert, let's run towards the light, which is pointing down on the top of the prison where Nagisa's dad it's just a lot. Where Nagisa's dad is in prison. And then out of the light, all the girls descend on a glowing stage.
Uh-huh.
And Chieri starts singing Nagisa no Cherry. Nagisa watches Chieri sing, is starting to look concerned. And then the WOTA from underground during this concert release all the detainees from this military prison. Including Nagisa's dad.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, you have to leave and you have to see Nagisa's first concert. So aww. He goes out, and then Nagisa sees him coming out of sees him coming out of his prison. And then mid-song, Chieri turns around to Nagisa and is like, your turn to sing. And then Nagisa has this internal struggle. Thankfully, the bridge of the song is really long.
Yeah, for real.
And then she goes up and she starts singing. And it's actually kind of cute because, like, her outfit, like, digitally changes from, like, a background dancer outfit to a front outfit. I think it was kind of cool. That's a good future tech.
Yeah, that's not the first time they do this either.
But that being said, the song, this dramatic moment, is not a dramatic song. It's just, like, a happy little pop song.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess you picked it because it was good idly. Names for your main characters, but, like, it's not the best song for the situation, but whatever.
Yeah, no.
And so they gave their new concert, and then all the audience starts screaming for an encore. So the girls go out, and they sing their encore song that Sensei came up with. Which is actually the ending song of every episode of the anime.
Hey.
The lyrics are kind of wild.
How so?
Well, it's like, it's my generation. Dreams are the reincarnation. Like, everything is reincarnation. Every time I dance is a reincarnation. You're like, what's going on?
Yeah.
But anyways, the Kiraras follow them all around. And then a whole bunch of Kiraras show up. and they all start glowing. And the photographer and Tsubasa start freaking out because the glow is similar to the last concert that Ah-chan was in. And it's not just Nagisa and Chieri who are glowing. It's all of the trainees.
Oh, shit. They're all going to explode.
The DES starts attacking. The trainees start getting ready to fight. But, like, the successors are like, no, this song is too important. And start backing them up. So, like, even Yuko and Takamina kind of have resolved that, like, yes, we're going to help these trainees no matter what, even if it means sacrificing ourselves. And then at some point in the tunnels, the...
Meanwhile in the tunnels. In the spooky tunnels.
The Kirarza succession decide that Takamina is Takamina again because of her desire to sacrifice herself to protect the concert. So you're like, okay... But why is Kanata still glowing? But that's fine. And Tsubasa's like, what does this mean for Kanata? And also, like, why did I hear Ah-chan's voice? And then out of nowhere, the words center nova start chanting. The Kiraras of Succession start glowing, showing images of all the trainees. Tsubasa's like, does that mean one of the trainees is, or like all of the trainees is on center nova?
Mm-hmm.
The trainees continue their performance. The next song they sing is the OP. And then, like, a big, giant, like, glowy mandala shows up behind them.
Uh-huh.
The photographer on the ground is like, oh, no, what's going to happen? The trainees start glowing, and they start ascending into the sky. The photographer lady's like, no, if you shine any brighter, you'll... And then the song ends, and the girls are okay.
I love this shit so much. It's so wild. If you shine any brighter, you'll get taken by the space gremlins.
And so, like, that's kind of the apex of the show, right? So everything else is, like, during credits, like, just some short wrap-up. So Tsubasa's like, I feel like we're one step closer to center nova. The photographer, after seeing this, like, notices that the soil on the ground is shiny. And she's like, dualium? Is that why the center nova phenomenon happened here?
And you're like, okay. What's that?
Nagisa reunites with their parents. They kind of encourage her and they're like, you won't be abandoning us if you go out. Her dad still is kind of tsundere about it, but you could tell he actually cares about her. Yuka says goodbye to her ex. Orine says goodbye to the mech that she created. And then Tsubasa comes up to Takamina and whispers something in her ear. And Takamina looks happy. And that's about it. There's season one of AKB.
Wow, we did it.
It was wild. I'm so glad I bought the DVDs.
Right? Like, Sarah, do you understand now why I've been trying to get you to watch this show for like 8 years?
I am so glad, Star. And in some ways, I'm glad I watched it after I've seen so many, like, other idol shows. Because, like, the tropes are there. They're just weird.
Yep. Fucking weird.
I think I'll give my full opinions on it after our next episode. But so far, it's wild and I love it and thank you for recommending it.
Yay! So we still got to do the second season. But have you watched the second season yet?
Not yet.
Okay. So based on what you know now, who is best girl?
I actually really like Takamina.
She's great. I told you like her.
I love her. I love, because again, I glossed over a lot because there's a lot of girls and there's a lot happening. But I really did like the conflict of like, I want to be a leader. But also, I know there's other people who are suited. And like the imposter syndrome with like the not just imposter syndrome, the actual like, you actually don't deserve this job. But yeah. I think she was a cool character.
Yeah. It's like, the drama was rough because, like, it felt legitimate, you know? Mm-hmm. Like, not like other drama where it's just like, oh, we'll solve this in 2 seconds. It's an ongoing problem because it's like, this could happen anywhere. It doesn't have to be idols in space. It's just an interesting character conflict. And I really, like, as hard as it was to watch because you're empathetic for these characters, like, it's still really interesting to see what they do about it.
Yeah, and it's also cool that it's, like, a hard situation where no one's wrong or no one's the bad guy except, I mean, I guess the cult.
Yeah.
But it's just really interesting.
Yeah. Fucking idol cult.
What about you, Star?
Yuko Oshima, best girl. But I also she's really good. Kanata's my favorite of the understudies.
Yeah, she's really good.
I love her.
I like Kanata a lot too, but I also ship her with Takamina, so big shrug to the sky.
So I guess the next question is, I know that cons aren't happening right now, but when are we gonna cosplay them? Because, you know, I've been waiting, Sarah. I've been waiting. For years.
I gotta work really hard to take on the name and image of Takamina before I become her.
Or you could just buy the costumes on eBay like I was gonna do.
Yeah, but then you're not really a successor, are you, Star?
I'm an imposter.
Imposter.
Everyone's, we at least need listen, Max. Sarah, everyone saw me vent. It's fine.
So yeah, next episode will be season two.
We will
see what happens if all these girls disappear. What is the center Nova? Is Sensei actually the wall?
Yes.
Yes. Is this just what happens before Idol Project happens? Is this what caused Idol Project to happen?
Oh god. The horror. But yeah, the Sarah, I will say, I've hinted about some of the stuff that happens in season two because I can't remember which episode it was. But I talked about how when I watched it on Crunchyroll, like, 8 freaking years ago, I accidentally started with season 2 and had no fucking idea what was going on. So, just next time on Idol Days, the show about idol animes, idol court drama.
Uh-oh.
That is the hint I will give you. Phoenix Wright, Ace Idol.
Yes. And hopefully I doubt we're gonna learn more about other girls, but right now there's only been like 4 that were important, but hopefully more.
There's gonna be some shit. I'm excited to hear your take on it when we get
there. I'm very excited too.
Yeah. So Sarah, if people want to find us on the internet, where can they go?
They can go to our website. That's idoldays.card.co, idoldays.card.co. You can also go to idolluminati.net.
Yep. Or .com. Both work.
If they want to interact with us on social media, where can they go, Star?
Yes. So we are on social media. We are on Twitter and Instagram at idoldayspod. That's at idoldayspod on Instagram and Twitter. We also have a Discord server. The link is available on our website, which Sarah just mentioned. So come hang out with us, talk about idols. We're also going to be having our first anniversary episode coming up soon. Woo-hoo. And I think part of it we decided we were going to do is we're going to take user mail or like listener mail. So if you guys want to send us a message that we can read on the show, like have a question or some commentary or like suggestions for the show, we'll be probably putting out like a form or something on both the website and the Discord and our various social medias. So be on the lookout for that.
Yeah, we love to hear from you.
Yeah.
So this has been Idol Days.
We've been Lady. See you next life. Bye.